Oh, well, thanks for that, John. Well, if you've just walked in, you've just missed a 5-0 thriller. What an FTK Cup final this turned out to be. Well, Alan, Black and Munich really turned it round in the second half. Obviously, what Herr Himmelt had to say to him at half-time must have really worked. But what do you think he was really looking for, though?
Was he wanted width, and he wanted pressure from his full-backs, and he's had that, and I think all goals have actually come from crosses and getting in behind them, which is what you have to do when you've got 10 and 11 bodies in front of you. You've got to actually stretch the teams and then get the goals from there, and they've done exactly that.
Well, now we'll have a look at some of the highlights and the goals from the first half, starting with the DFDS free kick in the opening minute.
You've got to work those areas when, as I said, when you've got 9 and 10 men behind the ball trying to defend it. Those are the areas you've got to try and get in behind. Quick, incisive passing like that is, and that's how you'll get your goals.
Well, the next came the penalty by Carl Holmes. Well, he just crumbled under the pressure, which led to a very disappointing penalty.
Total miss. So bad, it's almost unbelievable.
Very, very poor.
Well, Tony Blendle for DFDS, he had a couple of good chances in the first half. He was absolutely tearing the defence to pieces. They just couldn't keep up with him for his pace, off the ball runs. Well, let's have a look at those.
Look, when you stand still in a penalty box, you're easy to mark. And just watch his movement here. You've got him in the middle there. He actually goes around the defender and actually comes back in front of him. Look, he's not marking him there. He's still up. Oh, there you go. Just a little movement and a shimmy away from the defender, and the defender hasn't got a clue where he is. And that's great centre-forward play. When you know you've got a winger out there on the right wing, you can make runs like that all day.
Well, for Blendle's first goal, the defence was so far up, in the end they just paid the penalty.
This is an example of how far up the pitch, well, they are so deep it's unbelievable. The furthest man up the pitch there is the nine. So they've got everybody behind the ball, and then a little break here is a really good finish.
Then came Tony Booker's goal. Well, what a goal that was. He was making all the right movement up front, and when his chance came to him, he just took it.
When you're on a roll, like this is what happens. You just get a little bit of luck, touch there. Ball falls great to him. It's on his left foot and he finishes off very well.
Well, Tony Blendle had been causing the German back four problems all night long. And when the ball came to him, his persistence paid off with a great goal.
So he's lively, he's quick, sharp. Quick thinking, great first touch and a great finish.
With two players on him that tight, keep it that tight and then to finish it off was brilliant.
Well, the second half was a complete turnaround. Faster and aggressive, leading to a free kick to Black and Munich, taken by Ian Brown. But what a free kick this was. Let's have a look.
Very, very good free kick. He's got up and over the wall. That's a great free kick. Mm.
Never seen him taking too many.
He has scored a few, because he has got the technical ability to whip across in and take a free kick, because he's shown that. But, like, he is really just so dogged in there, you know what I mean?
Well, the equaliser came from Tony Booker. And what a nice build-up and what a nice goal.
Played it wide. It's a nice bit of interplay here for him. Plays it through, a lucky little break. A fantastic finish in his left foot.
Next level could David Umbongo Bowman, the Trinidadian's header. It's a great header, and this one could have took him into the lead.
This is a great, great cross.
I mean, that is a great ball and cross. He climbs early, as he always does.
Well, that was followed up by a spectacular combination of Bowman and Foster. Great play, but very unlucky. Let's have a look at this.
Even before the hit, if you watch it closely, he's watching for the fullback to jump. He's actually taking a step back just there. Look, just goes a step back. First touch is magnificent.
He's got to have half a chance of going over the top.
Well, in the second half, Black and Munich changed the tactics. They pushed up from the middle and from both flanks, and it paid off.
Which is what you have to do when you've got 10 and 11 bodies in front of you. You've got to actually stretch the teams and then get the goals from there, and they've done exactly that.
Poor Carl Holmes. He was under so much pressure. Could the Black and Munich fans really expect him to score?
They're not expecting, they're demanding.
Goals. And even if you do score, you're expected to. So he's making all the right moves, and I'm pleased that he's scored.
Time and time again, the quality of the ball. Again, he's up against this young left back. Quality of the ball, very good movement, and a great finish.
And the thing about it is that he's been doing stuff like the ball just hasn't been running to him. He's kept doing it, and now he's got his reward by getting a little tap in.
Brilliant. Superb strike, really is. Meant it, didn't it?
Yeah. I'm telling you.
Whether you like it or not, centre-forwards are judged on goals.
Well, thanks for your views, gents. We now go pitchside to see Sir Trevor Smith and Tony Nine presenting the medals and the trophy to the teams. Well, as you join me back at pitchside, commiserations to the losers there. There's McShelley and the manager Paul Gonzalez has a gutsy Sir Trevor Smith and Tony Knight. There's a referee coming up for his medals, William Anker, the linesman T. Ospot and Rentschen Akaroff, and here come the cup winners. There's Mandlers, the only German in the side. John Foster, what a great game he had. Ian Brown, great free kick specialist. Jimmy Hargreaves, Tony Booker, Krustowski, there he is, receiving his medal. And there's a manager, here him up, and his assistant, Tezza Taylor, as they come up to the podium. And there's the captain, Stevie McIntyre, just having a word with Sir Trevor Smith. And here it is, as he's just receiving the trophy, the winners of the 06 FTK Cup Final are Black and Munich. And just listen to the crowd. What a great game this was. Well deserved. And a great fan. And it's back to you in the studio. Well, I'm sure the players and the fans will be celebrating all night tonight after this great victory. Well, that's about it from us tonight. All it leaves me to say is thank you to my guests in the studio. And if you've got any thoughts on the cup final, send your views to www.subbuteoforum.co.uk. If you want to see the players and the manager merging from the dressing rooms, press your red button now. We'll go straight to that. And all I'd like to say now is thanks for viewing and see you next season. Good night. To the